Hello. Hi, everybody. This is Jennifer Jordan, and I'm here on Crossroads Church of Dunwoody's page today as the prayer 404 prayer initiative person for today. So I hope everybody is doing well. I know this is such a weird time that we are all social distancing and not being able to come to church, not being able to go very many places unless it's a necessity, and it's kind of a weird time that we're living in. I think this is such a great idea that we are taking back some time on the internet and so that we can share some hope. And where do we get our hope? We get our hope from God. And so I think this is so great. And so today I'm going to share one of my favorite verses. And if you were to ask me, what is your favorite verse? This is probably the one that I would say is my absolute favorite. And I have a lot of favorites, but this is definitely the one that I would share the most. So I'm going to read that, and then we'll pray together. So the verse that I've chosen is Romans 15:13, and this is what it says. May the God of hope fill you with all joy and peace in believing, so that by the power of the Holy Spirit you may abound in hope. And I love that verse in a normal time, because it talks about God being a God of hope and that he's the one that can fill us up with the joy and the peace. And then it's not by any power that we have, but it's by the power of the Holy Spirit that we can abound in hope. And I think that right now we are living in a time where everybody's looking for answers in a lot of different places. And my hope and my prayer is that more people will turn their hearts to God, and so that he can fill them up and he can give them the peace and the hope and the joy that he promises us in his word. So if you would take just a moment with me and pray, I'd like to pray for us all that we can be able to handle what's going on in our lives. Each of us have different things that are struggles right now, and I just want to pray for that, and then just pray that we can, whatever we do, that this can be a time that we can bring God glory and honor. Father, we thank you so much that we can come to you. We know that you're a God that hears us. You're a God that wants to hear from us. You want us to come to you. You want us to bring our concerns to you. And we thank you, God, that we know that you are in control of all things. And we know that coronavirus was not a shock to you. We know that this quarantine and everything that's going on is not a surprise. And I just pray, God, that you would help us to trust you and to know that you are still in control, even when everything in the world seems crazy and out of reach, or it seems like we're in despair. Pray that we can just continue to trust in you and know that you are in control and that things will work out and what your plan is. Father, we thank you so much that you are always here for us to come and talk to. You can... You're always hearing what we are crying out to you about, or what we are giving you praise for, that you are always there for us and you never leave us. And we thank you so much for that. And God, just as this verse says, that you are the God of hope and peace and joy. And I just pray that, God, for each of us, that you would help us to seek you and to seek that you would give us the peace that we can handle each day right now, and that we can, even if we might be scared to go out, or we might be scared of getting coronavirus, or we might be scared that our finances are out of whack, or whatever our struggles might be, God, that we can just put all of that at your feet and know that you can give us a peace about it and that you can help us make it through. And God, I just pray that right now you would give us all some hope that the future is going to be okay, that we are all going to be okay. 2020 has started off crazy, but we are going to make it through this, and I just pray that you give us the strength that we need, and that you would help fill us up with hope, even if it's just hope for the rest of today or hope for tomorrow, but each new day that we could come to you and ask for your help, God, and know that you're going to give it to us. I thank you so much that we can be in our homes and be safe and secure, and I pray that you continue to provide for each of us, that we could have all of our needs met, and God, that you would just help us to continue to seek your face each day, and know that you hear us, and that you're our great helper, and that you are here for us to talk to and to praise. And we do praise you, God, and thank you for everything that you've done for us. And we pray that the things during this quarantine that we are doing would still continue to bring you glory and honor, that you would help us to stay on the course that we know is correct, and you'd help us to continue to read our Bibles and to pray to you and to do your work. And we pray all these things in Jesus' precious name. Amen. All right, so now the challenge is there for you. I pray that you would contact Pastor Chris or leave a comment or whatever, and that you would take on the challenge and do the 404 prayer initiative. Thanks, and hope to see you soon. Bye.